Did y'all do Divorce Father Day? See, that's what I called it. When I was coming up, they had this thing where when your parents got divorced, your father was supposed to take you on Saturday to go do shit. I called it Divorce Father Day because I was a little smart-ass little kid. So today, in today's world, when they do Divorce Father Day, you take your kids, you go get ice cream, you go to the park. You sit around and discuss life in the trees. See, that's not what Divorce Day was when I was a kid. See, when I was a kid, Divorce Day was a day that your father got shit done and made you do it. So, like, on Divorce Father Day, which was supposed to be so wonderful, since I'm so affluent and I grew up my physician father. And so, for Divorce Father Day, my father loved to have us work in the yard. See, he had a house over there in Baldwin Hills with a little hill behind it. And he had us you know that Mayan level shit that you see the Mayans go down and level out as you go down the hill? My father had us do that shit on the hill behind his house. I am not bullshitting. We called it the Great Wall because there was a wall up top. Then he actually had us carve. Into the hillside, like a walkway. And you would walk down and he had tiers like the Mayan shit with growing strawberries. So on Divorce Father Day, when we would tend this shit, my father would pick strawberries and blueberries and then he would make wonderful cocktails for himself and his friends. Daiquiris, strawberry daiquiris. He would give us some fruit too. But meanwhile, I was working the Mayan hill that I built under my father's direction. Have you seen that shit? Who thinks of that? Who thinks of that? And I had some West Indian friends, who Jamaicans, whose parents owned property. Oh, see, I didn't complain because their weekend was worse than mine. Every Jamaican friend I had, their parents worked them like dogs. Because, you know, Jamaicans, they say you're 7 years old, you only have one job. They worked their ass off. But my old man on Divorce Father Day, sometimes my old man would come get me on Divorce Father Day. Because he lived right across and, you know, in the adjoining neighborhood. Right. So my old man would come get me on Divorce Father Day. Get me started in the yard, and he would disappear, you know. And then he would come back with a car load of shit. He would come back with his car, the trunk open, bags of shit, trays of flowers and plants, backseat covered with drapes to protect the seat, and then load it up. Even the front passenger, my old man would pull up with all that shit in the car. And we knew that was it. So this is you would unload all that shit and then proceed. So you know what was the good part of Divorce Father Day? At the end of the day, after working you like a slave. Oh, by the way, my father's gracious now. So while you worked, oh, there was Orange Crush, Strawberry Crush. Big old giant nectarines and apples and cold cuts. He would get the cold cuts in the deli section with the sliced cheeses and shit and the different breads. So you could take a break and eat, but your ass better get back to work. See, Hubert would feed you good and then work you. And then at the end of that day, he would make a wonderful dinner and we'd sit around all stinky and eat. And he would talk about how wonderful a day we had. That's Divorce Father Day for my time. I hope your Divorce Father Day was very different.